Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Simsalaiza and today we're building a container home in the new Port Promise neighborhood in Evergreen Harbor. For this build, I actually took some real life inspiration because I do want to have a container house in the near future, and I try to keep the dimensions as close to the containers next to it as I could. You see, I just figured out how to place the third container on top. So you basically have a U-shape if you look from the bird's eye perspective, which creates a nice outside area on the bottom. And I did want to have it sheltered so you can even use it when it's raining. And now we're just doing some colorful containers because I think that's the fun in a container house. And why not show off your mismatched old shipping containers? To get some light in, I placed a lot of the new sliding doors, which are just great. And of course, there are ladders in this build since we will be using the roof area as well. So you have one ladder going up from what will be the inside yard and one from the outside, and all of them have living roofs. And the very top is where the solar panels and windmills will be. So yeah, it's gonna be really, really good, and of course eco-friendly and all the good stuff. Yeah, here you have the solar panels. I did place them so the Sims can get to both sides, and I did put the windmills as well so you can access them and repair them if needed. Also, of course, there are vertical gardens as well as the new dew collector, and I did want to put the tent shelter thingy down, but that just looked strange, so sorry, this is not in the build. Yeah, and now we're getting to the inside of the containers. I wanted to put a sliding door right there so you could access what will be the bedroom really quickly, and also just having the vertical gardens on one side I think is more practical. So yeah, you have the sliding door, which gives a lot of light from the one side. It's one of the most important things in my opinion for a tiny home, that you have enough light so it doesn't feel small and dingy. So you see on the other side we have those nice big windows looking in the harbor, which right now looks not that great, but you know, once your Sims moved in and improved the eco footprint, it will be great. Also more sliding doors on the bottom as well, opening up to the inside yard area. This yellow one is gonna be sort of the living room, I think. Or was that the kitchen and is the living room on the other side? I forgot. I think it's the other way around. Yeah, we have the kitchen on the right side, and on the left side we have the living slash workspace. The good thing about this build, in my opinion, I think, is once your Sim is ready to have a family, you can just add another container either on the bottom or on top. In real life, I think it would make more sense to put it on top because you have all of the water installations already in one container, so it's easier to just put another bathroom on top instead of having to reconfigure it all again. So yeah, that's just my two cents about that. So we're getting to the bathroom here, and as I said, I tried to use as many of the new items as I could, and which made sense. This is, I think, the first time I used that mirror because it gives a little bit more light. And since it's a really big bathroom, there's room for a tub, and of course there's room for a big old window out the back so you can sit in a bathtub and look outside, look onto the water, which I think is really pretty. So yeah, that's the bathroom for you. We'll just put down some decorations here and there, towels and toilet paper, and I think I did want to put a rug. I'm not sure if it fitted in the end. No. Yeah, moving on to the kitchen. For me, a full-size kitchen is one of the small luxuries, if you will, that I would really want in a container home because I like to cook. And I have a small kitchen now, and I think there's nothing worse than having to cook on just two hot plates and have a small fridge and not a real oven. So yeah, I did go all out on the kitchen, as you can see here. And also, not only do we have the overhead cabinets, I also did want some light underneath, because you would have in a real kitchen. So I fitted those underneath, and I think I fixed them later with the height so that they're really hidden. Not that you would see in normal gameplay, but that just looked a little wonky, so I tried to fix it as well. And yeah, there you go. That's the nice little kitchen that's already in the house, or that the house comes with. Of course, there's also fire alarm, so if your Sims do set the kitchen on fire, there will be at least the firemen and women to rescue them as well. Okay. As for the rest of the room, I did want to have a place to eat in case it's cold outside or really hot, or you just don't feel like going out. And I did want to try and fit it in. As you can see right now, I'm just on small appliances. So I put some coffee maker, and of course I want the espresso machine, because why not? If you're gonna spend some money, you might as well do it properly. So I extended the kitchen a little further into the room, just so that you can have more than one counter to prepare some food, which for some meals you just need a little more space. And then I did want to put a bar in, so you could just sit there if it's cold outside or too hot. So if you don't feel like going outside, you'd have an alternative where you could eat. Of course, the Sims will just run out anyway, knowing them. Yeah, and then we're moving on to the living space. Of course, there's a TV. As always, me choosing furniture takes a little while, and also I wasn't quite sure which vibe I was going for. And I did finally settle on sort of bohemia, hippy-dippy sort of stuff. So we have this beautiful wicker couch. We have a little coffee table. I couldn't fit the new one in because it's just so big. So we have a small coffee table and mismatched armchairs. So if you have friends over, you can actually sit and have a nice talk. And of course, there's a colorful rug and some plants to brighten up the place a little bit, which of course I cannot care for. That is, like, I can do a lot of things, but keeping plants alive is not one of them. Yeah, and then once I was into the plants, I just did them outside as well, because, well, might as well. And going back inside, there was the succulents that I placed on the wall, which, as I said, I think are really, really pretty. And also, they don't take a lot of water, so I might just not kill them. Moving on, there was one more little coffee table with a plant on top that I couldn't resist. And then I also wanted a place for a yoga mat. I like doing yoga, and I think right in front of the sliding door would be really pretty. In the corner there, you'd have your office space, a small desk, and the desktop PC, the yoga mat, as I said, in front there. And there's room for a stereo, and it doesn't crowd the container. So yeah, I think it's quite nice. Moving on to the outside, I first of all plopped the wall down between the two containers, and then I took out every other piece, as I said, to actually create a cross breeze, and I thought that there would be a new fence to just accommodate basically what I wanted to do. And in the back I also did put the wall down. I think in the front I'll take it down later, because there wouldn't be actually room to get into the yard space except for when you move into the house and then outside. So yeah, I decided to make use of the new fence that we have, which is also pretty pretty, and just put a hole in there. Because of course there isn't a matching gate, seriously, Sims team. If you create these beautiful fences, why can't there be a gate to go with it? The other new fence is on top, so you'd have privacy there as well. Put down the living roof again, because it deleted, and then I tried to figure out how to actually place sort of a roof, glass roof type, on top of the patio area without creating an additional room. I ended up using the glass bottom tiles that came with Island Living, because they don't actually count as a roof. They also look pretty, and once I've all arranged them, it looks just like a flat rooftop that you would use in real life as well, so the walls can be deleted. I don't know if that would count towards the floor tiles, because even though this is a container home, it's not actually a tiny home. I didn't change the lot type when I started building. Anyway, moving on to the patio. Of course, there's the little cute grill that came with movie stuff or patio stuff. Probably patio would make more sense. And a light wooden table with nice chairs around them as well. And you would have your plants to have a nice climate and also to, yeah, just look nice. I really like that outside area, if I do say so myself. I'm moderately proud of this build, because it really comes close to what I want to have in real life. There are, of course, two bicycles for your Sims to ride around with, and further decrease the eco footprint. And I think that's it. I put some candles down and some twinkly lights, so it would be very well lit at night, and some more of the fairy lights to just go across and create some atmosphere. So there's a column so your lights don't just end in midair, to add to the realism. And I think that's it for the patio area, so just keep rearranging the bikes, and yeah, then we move on to the upstairs outside balcony, however you want to call it. So yeah, just here and there some more details, and upstairs on the left side I put down two of the insect hotels. So if you want, you can eat them or make fuel out of them or just have them as pets. And of course there's a dumpster for all your recycling and dumpster diving needs. And I forgot a bin in the kitchen, so there it is. There is no laundry this time in the build. I couldn't fit it, and honestly I thought it would just ruin the build if I tried to cram in a washer or anything. So yeah, you just saw me putting down these nice curtains, which in real life would hopefully block out all the light from coming in. And then I put down, yeah, the juice fizzer is there. I've reduced it to one insect hotel, so a little less fuel for you. And also the lounge chairs on the other side. With the little fence there, no one will be able to see you when you relax. And there is a birdhouse. I think I put the birdhouse down, yeah. And I wanted to fit the big umbrella So, your Sims don't get sunburn. I know they don't actually do anything, it just looks nice. And inside, I wanted to have not only a big bedroom, but also another little private lounge area with a fireplace and some books, so you and your partner could cozy up there and read in the winter, or you just lounge around outside in the summer with a nice homemade cocktail, whatever you want. I put plants down in the area as well as a rug, which I sincerely hope doesn't catch on fire the first time you actually light it. Did I mention how much I like the new build mode stuff? I don't think I have. Yeah, so moving a little bit back and forth between the inside and outside here and there, having a little detail added like the bird's house or lamps, and also you have the big space where the bed would be, as well as a little dressing area if you wanted. If your Sims do have a child, you wouldn't actually need a second container right away. I think you might just be get away with putting a wall down and having it as a little nursery where the sitting area is. So yeah, it's a very expandable build. There's the new bed, also with a beautiful look out onto the water, and as I said, dressing area and here and there little details that make it cozy. And I also put down a chair, you know, a laundry chair. Don't lie, you also have one. And I think that's it for the build mode for now. I think we're finished. So in a second, we're just gonna jump into night mode to see it all lit up and beautiful. And yeah, that's, as I said, that's the finished build. I did take a couple of pictures for you. You can see the build from all sides and how it fits into the surroundings, which I think is quite nice, and from the top view as well. And then you have the yard section and the bikes, as well as the kitchen and the bathroom with the bathtub in front of that really pretty bay window looking out the living room right here and the bedroom on the top floor. This build is on the gallery. Just type in my name, Simzalaiza, and you can find it. If you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye!